All right, hello everyone and welcome back to Kotobo's Space Program, where today we are having a look at the Other Worlds mod, which was originally made way back in the day by forum user PKM Nyako, but has since been updated to version 1.3 of Kerbal Space Program by user TheMaster401. And this is another one of those mods I could have sworn I made a video of already ages ago, but apparently not. So here we are, and what this glorious little piece of work does look to add into the game is something I truly love, and that is a whole new star system. I always love the planet packs that add in new stars chock full of new planets, so let's go right on down to the tracking station and have a gander at what we do get. Now, what's interesting about this one, a lot of the planet packs that do add in new star systems add something like a black hole that both of the star systems, the original and the new one, orbit around. This one, on the other hand, makes the new star system, the Sursani system, orbit around our existing home star, which is kind of hard to see here because the orbit line is black, but if I angle it slightly there so we can see the lines, you can tell the orbit to some degree. But it's quite interesting. So this whole system is slowly but surely orbiting around our home world. So let us go and take a look at the new star we do have, again named Sursani, which is roughly half the size and half the brightness of Kerbal, but you know, it should provide plenty of light for your endeavors to this lovely little system. So let's start with the first planet, which is Trani, a tiny little world, which, if I actually do bring up the info panel here, is only 150 kilometers in radius and is tidally locked with the star, as you can see there, so that one side is basically a barren hellscape and the other is just a giant chunk of frozen ice. And I always quite enjoy worlds like that. I find them interesting to explore, especially areas like this where it seems a little bit weird that that ice is pushed forward. Very cool indeed, but it does have no atmosphere, so that is certainly something to keep in mind. Now, the next planet we have is Vasa, which is vastly bigger at 420 kilometers and is also tidally locked, but unlike Trani, this one's made of water. So we have just this giant ocean world with a giant ice world on the other side, which I love. Very cool, though, as you can see, there are a few spots on the ice that you could try to land a boat in and go and explore these, I guess technically you'd still call them lakes, or, well, that size might be a small ocean. Very cool, and does have an atmosphere, one that is a bit thinner than our homeworld atmosphere, is what I was trying to say there, and, of course, has a very tiny and very closely orbiting moon. I don't know why, but that just kind of seems a bit too close. It feels like it should be entering the atmosphere at any moment and exploding. But yes, this is C2-1, which is only 20 kilometers in radius with no atmosphere, and kind of looks like a giant ball of trash. But you know what? Could be a fun one to go and jump around on. Now, the next planet that we have is Pequar. Oh boy, I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right in the slightest, but it's by far my favorite planet because, oh yeah, it has a ring. I love ring worlds. And not just rings, it also has two very large ice caps, one on the top and bottom. It does have a fairly thin atmosphere, actually about as thin as Vasa, so, you know, roughly the same amount there, and is quite large, though. It's 780 kilometers, and overall a very cool-looking planet with lots of differing terrain, good differentiation between the ice caps, the center band, and, of course, again, the lovely giant yellow ring. Who doesn't love that? And as you can see, we do have two moons for this place, one being C3-1, which is basically a caught asteroid at 15 kilometers in size and is oddly yellow. Interesting. And the other moon, which is Disol. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right in the slightest either, but this one is 252 kilometers in size, does have an atmosphere at 0.6 atmospheres, and a pretty interesting little planet. Lots of small little pot-marked areas, and then a couple of large craters, and a few very intriguing areas like that that could be fun to explore. But yes, that is the second moon here, so let us move on to the next planet then, which is Nienna, which is the largest of the planets in this system at 2,400 kilometers, and as you can see, also has a number of things orbiting it at different angles, which is always fun. And also does have, I think, a very thin ring. I keep thinking that that's another moon orbiting it, but no, it's a very thin ring around the planet, which is quite cool. I do enjoy that. And yeah, it's giant. It does have an atmosphere, but at 0.009 atmospheres, atmospheric pressure. So yeah, interesting world to go to. And then the next one we have, the moon here at least, is Kevari, which is probably the most colorful planet in this entire system. Very interesting looking, and what look like octopus suckers all over the planet. But no, those are, I guess, craters. And then, oh, I forgot to mention the size of this one, 222 kilometers. It does have an atmosphere, though as similarly as slightly pressured as the planet it orbits. And then we have Krones, again, very similarly colorful. No atmosphere on this one, but it does have a pretty decent size at 330 kilometers and quite the interesting orbit, as we can see right here. And then finally we have Cousin Nico, which has the most eccentric of all the orbits around this planet, is the smallest as well at 132 kilometers. Ooh, am I right on that? Yes, this was 222. For a second, I thought that was 120, but no. 132 on Cousin Nico down here. A pretty, you know, gray world, similarly in color to our moon, but no atmosphere. Small little planet, 132 kilometers, but overall, a pretty nice place. And then we have Prima, which is, you know, pretty small little planet with a very eccentric moon around it. Now, Prima has no atmosphere on it and is 252 kilometers in size. And overall, just a nice, interesting little world. Nicely pot-marked on one side, fairly smooth on the other, which I find intriguing. Could be fun to explore. And then finally, we have the moon around it, which is Secunda, another greenish thing. No atmosphere, 222 kilometers in size, and pretty nicely pot-marked, and some interesting changes in terrain all around the place. I do enjoy it. A very nice moon to go and explore. But yes, that is it for the Sersani system within the Other Worlds mods. Let's just go take a quick trip out to the crappy little spaceship that I made out here, and which I lovingly placed inside the ring because, I mean, come on, who again doesn't want to visit a ringed world? It's just cool. So we'll end the video by taking a bit closer of a look here at Prequar, again, I have no idea how to pronounce that thing, but it's a very cool planet nonetheless. You gotta love the just gigantic yellow ring with the beautiful view of the star in the background and just, you know, some nice decent moons close by over there. Overall, a beautiful world in a beautiful system inside of a beautiful mod. So if you would like to take a look at this star system for yourself, and I would definitely suggest that you go and do that, you can take a look at the link in the description as per usual. But that is going to be it really for this episode. Not a whole lot more to talk about with these things. I don't want to ruin the surprises on the planets. Go and explore them yourself, my friends. But that is going to be it for today. I hope you all have enjoyed, and of course that you do come back for the next episode when hopefully we'll be looking at another wonderful mod. But until that time, thank you for watching, and as always, have a good one!